stories. Good afternoon, your favorite history teacher, Mr. Pineda. Hopefully you guys had a great day today. I know I did with my second, fourth, sixth, and eighth. Tomorrow I'll go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and see third and fifth. Ladies and gentlemen, very simple. I'm going to go ahead and talk to you about the three battles of the American Revolution. Today we're going to be starting a new PowerPoint, which is on the Articles of Confederation, the weak Articles of Confederation. So ladies and gentlemen, let me go ahead and not keep you waiting. First battle of the American Revolution, Lexington and Concord. Let's remember, ladies and gentlemen, when they went to Lexington and Concord, they were looking for a couple of things, three to be exact. They were looking for weapons, Hancock, and Samuel Adams. Again, the shot heard around the world. That's the nickname for the Battle of Lexington and Concord. Nobody knows who shot first. I'm gonna say that the British did. Second one, the Battle of Saratoga, known as the turning point of the war. It is called the turning point of the war, ladies and gentlemen, because here, from this point on, the colonists will start defeating the British from that point on, okay? And I'm trying to look over here. So again, from that point on, the colonists start defeating the British. That's why it's called the turning point of the war. And not only that, ladies and gentlemen, here, after the Battle of Saratoga, after we defeat the British in the Battle of Saratoga, the French are going to see that we can actually defeat the British. After the Battle of Saratoga, they will become our allies. So again, guys, it's very important that you remember this. France will become our allies. France will be attacking by sea, and we'll be attacking by land. This is going to be crucial in the Battle of Yorktown. In the Battle of Yorktown, ladies and gentlemen, all you need to remember that here is where Lord Cornwallis will have no other choice than to go ahead and surrender. Again, I'll tell you why. I told you right now, but I'll repeat myself again. In the Battle of Yorktown, France is attacking by sea. We are attacking by land. They have no other option than to surrender to the American forces. Again, guys, Lexington and Concord, Saratoga, Yorktown. The last thing that you need to remember, so the Treaty of Paris, 1783, all you need to remember on this one, once we sign the Treaty of 1783, we will go ahead and by signing this, the American Revolution is recognized as being over. Not only that, guys, the British will recognize the colonies as not being colonies anymore, but as being an independent nation. From that point on, we're not the colonies anymore. We're going to be the United States of America. Not only that, guys, up north, Canada is our border. Down south, Florida will be our border. And towards the west, no longer will the Appalachian Mountains be our boundary, but we're going to extend all the way to the Mississippi River. Ladies and gentlemen, I told you I was going to keep it slow. I was going to keep it short to the point. Hopefully I did. Tomorrow, guys, we're going to go ahead and start a new PowerPoint, Articles of Confederation. And more than likely, after I end this video, more than likely, I'm going to give you a couple of questions to answer. Not sure yet. More than likely, yes. See you tomorrow. Remember to love U.S. history. Bye.